Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, everyone.
How's it going?
We're Free Planet Radio. Welcome to our live stream concert series. Woo-hoo. Saturday night, September 26th, from Rivers Teaching Studio at Odyssey School. Do you have a name for it?
Asheville Rhythm Studios.
Asheville Rhythm Studio.
Boom. Teaching, recording, so many things happening here. Education, wow. Live concert. And we have Adam who's going to join us in a little bit, so make sure you stay tuned for that. We're going to do a few songs ourselves first.
This is a group composition called Karslamar Variations.
Thank you.
Nice.
All right.
Karslamar variation.
Cool. Thanks for hanging on to that. If you were counting along, that's an old rhythm in 9/8, and those breaks were in 17/8 if you were counting along. So hope you enjoyed it.
We're going to do, it's kind of a new song for us. We did it, I wrote this maybe 10 years ago, and we never quite got it totally happening. I think maybe we performed it once, and it's been on the shelf for 10 years. And we pulled it out and polished it up, and I think it's sounding great now. Yeah, if we can play it. it's called Sunflower Code, and it's called that because the main rhythm is based on the Fibonacci series. So if you're listening closely to this intro that Eliot and I are doing, it's 1 1 2 3 5 8, and then back down if you're counting the rhythm. Feel free to sing along. Yeah. Sunflower Code.
Thank you.
Yeah. Job, Chris. Sunflower Code.
Sunflower Code.
Yeah. That's good. That's probably, we haven't, yeah, it's a long time we played that, and it's not in that way. So thanks for listening and tuning in. And we have Brandy Mazilka-Hubiak here. She knows from our Wednesday streaming. She's over there running all the cameras and running the chat and running the live things. There's so many things going on that she's doing. If you have any questions or comments, she's going to get to them as much as she can. And she can relate anything to us, too, if needed, right?
Yeah. She also lots of people saying hello.
Hello, everybody out
hello.
There. Yes. And if you are inspired to donate to the musical cause, Brandy also made up a place where you can do that for Free Planet Radio, and it would all be super, super worthwhile and appreciated. But if not, don't worry about it. Just sit back and enjoy the music.
This is a another old song that we've kind of revamped. This was on our first CD, and it's loosely based on the Raga Lalit, but not exactly, so we call it Lalit's Friend.
Thank you. All right, that was Lalit's Friend. An old, digging that one up back from our album New Bedouin Dance. Pretty much all five of our albums are streamable on Spotify or Apple Music or Bandcamp or all the free ways you want to listen to. A lot of people don't realize that. They see us locally like, wow, you're on Spotify? Yeah, it's okay. It's not super hard. If Elliot's got a Spotify account, you can do it too. But it's cool, and it's a great way to listen to the music. So that one goes back from our first record was made in the year, was it 2004?
2004,
this is
yeah.
our 2021 will be our 20th year, I think, as an ensemble, correct?
Yes, if we're going to do a special tour. from here.
The other side of the room.
We're going to go around the block.
That's right. Right. And we're going to thank, we've got some sponsors that are helping us keep this going. And one of them is Mosaic Realty. They've been a Asheville Percussion Festival sponsor since 2017. Big thanks to Mike Figura, who's the owner of Mosaic Community Lifestyle Realty, mymosaicrealty.com. Thank you so much, Mike. And
thank you. Get a drum roll for that.
That's
at least.
Good. I like that.
And some donuts and things.
Make sure this is happening.
Oh, yeah. We can hear you.
We're going to do another. This is another group composition that we, I guess, River started with a drum pattern with his class. And then. I put some notes to it.
Yep.
And we've worked it up.
Yep. It's actually.
It's called 16 Eighths.
It's a derivation of a piece called 17 Eighths from an album way
There's
back.
An album on our second album has a song called 17 Eighths. This is one less eight.
This is the cousin to that. So enjoy it. Not too fast, right? Thank you. Whew, sweet. There's a lot of notes in that one.
It might have been, one tiny flub in there, maybe. We're not going to admit to anything.
This next piece is called 11 Pieces, and this was written a while ago before our China tour, and we played this in China about 30 times, in many,
exactly
many,
30
exactly 30 times, in 30 different cities, and it was a lot of fun, and boy, the inspiration for this was such a long time ago. This was one of the snowflakes. When we did this in China, they would do snowflakes because I mentioned that I wrote this in the snowstorm one day. So they would always project snowflakes behind us. It was funny. But it's in 11, if you haven't guessed. And I think it stays in 11 most of the time, except for when Chris goes into his beautiful solo in the middle of the piece. And you can't wait for you to hear all of you to hear that. Okay, I got it. Good?
Yes.
Two for nothing? Thank you.
right. Who's right? Thank you, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for listening to us. We're about to have a special guest coming up in a minute. As they set up, we would like to thank another one of our special sponsors. And if you've noticed, just in a few weeks ago, I got this really amazing bass drum. It's a one-piece walnut drum that's steam bent, and it started from this snare drum that Jeff Hankin at Carolina Drumworks made for me. They call it the Asheville snare drum. It's actually only 12 inches wide, as most snare drums are 14 inches, and actually goes 7 inches deep, and he's got a nice wood rim on it, and it's just super, super gorgeous, and it's been on 100 recordings at this point, at least. Did you know that, Jeff? And it's brilliant. Engineers really love it. It's really light. It's got an amazing bevel. I could play it with my hands or sticks. And he also created this really gorgeous floor tom. It's also a piece of walnut bent. And it's really, really tremendous. I could play it with my hand. And it's got a really, really nice tone for all different things I can do. I muffle it. I could unmuffle it. The options are endless. We definitely want to thank Jeff Hankin and Carolina Drumworks for helping to make this happen today and providing some beautiful drums. So if you live in Asheville or beyond, wherever you live, he can make a drum that's special for you. Thank you. And then and now we have a drum roll for a 10-finger drum roll. Woo-hoo. For direct from these days Greenville, Adam Maalouf. And you might recognize Adam. He was at the original drum festival. He's been at all the drum festivals, the Asheville Percussion Festival, excuse me, except for the one about the celebrating in women, which was a great one too, but we missed you on that one. But hey, it was a good cause. And we want to thank Adam for coming here. He lived in New York City. If you remember, he moved there for about 5 years or so.
7 years.
7 years. Woo! I first met Adam, I think he was 14 or 15, yeah. And took some lessons back when I lived on Brooklyn and here in Asheville, and he'd been in and out, and he's really a tremendous artist, and he's got a really wonderful musical talent, and he's got a great ear. He plays so many instruments. You'll see him playing cello and percussion, and of course the handpans, which he'll maybe, are you willing to talk about this first piece, Adam?
Yeah.
Is that cool? You want to just go into it and play?
Yeah, sure. Well, I wrote both of these pieces for this experience to play with Free Planet Radio. Haven't really workshopped them in any other setting, and wrote them with these guys in mind, basically. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Were those world
Adam
premieres?
Maalouf.
Both of them world Both premieres. Both of them world.
Did you mention the names?
The first one is called Echoes, and the second one is a working title, Morning Sketch.
Oh, yeah. Works. I like it. Beautiful. Thank you, Adam. You composed these for this special occasion just for you. Wow. Thank you.
But only after listening to 150 hours of Free Planet Radio.
So many interesting stories. One of the ways we found out, or I'm not sure how, we found out about you, you found out us, your mom, Diane, she used to run this. Does she still run that? The Suzuki? No.
Yeah, she gave that up years ago, but.
But that's how we met.
The festival still happens.
The festival is, yeah.
Yeah.
We played over there. That was really nice in Greenville, and his mom set up this whole concert and was part of this camp and music appreciation and exposing the kids to different kinds of music and music from different parts of the world, music without borders. So it was really, really great. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
Cool.
We're going to do a song that River and I learned from Omar Farouk Tekbilek when we were playing in his band. It's the tune he does. It's an old Anatolian folk tune in 7/8. Feel free to count along at home, unless you're driving.
might keep you alert.
Yeah, maybe it's good. Might end up on the wrong side of the road. But
you might.
This is called Hijaz Mandara.
All right. Sounds good.
You guys are going to do a little break in the middle?
I think so.
Okay.
All right. That's good. 2/7. Thank you. That's what happens when you let two drummers lead a song. Sorry, guys. Sorry, I know that was fast. Sorry.
We'll never do a drum solo in the middle before again. That's definitely as fast as we've ever played.
All right. Elliot's sweating. It's officially a gig now. And it's not a gig until Elliot sweats.
That was a race to the finish.
I owe you a beer afterwards.
It's fun,
thank
though.
You. It's thank you. Thank you.
I think we're going to thank another sponsor.
Yes.
We're going to thank another sponsor. We would like to thank Mark Lauer Realty. Mark Lauer Realty is a local independent broker in Saluda, North Carolina. And Mark is a musician and a longtime Free Planet Radio fan and has been on the Asheville Percussion, been an Asheville Percussion Festival volunteer. I'm sure many of you know the Asheville Percussion Festival, but that's River and Asheville Rhythms mm-hmm. Festival that they've put together for how many years now?
9 years, I think.
9 years?
9 years.
Wow.
And we've all been part of it. I think Adam was part of it from the very beginning, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And 2011.
That was the first year.
Wow. On COVID hiatus right now.
Yes. What are we doing, Chris?
We're going to do a different version of a song we've been doing for a long time. This is Tangoa, our Indian / Argentinian song. And normally we play it on the dotar, but we're going to do it on piano with cello, another instrument Adam plays very well.
Don't set the standard too high.
Thank you.
bass.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed. That was lovely. Old country.
All right. The song is a little bit...
What?
A little bit old time.
A little old time.
Mountain.
A mountain.
But then also a little bit Middle Eastern, so we call it the old country.
The old country. We mix
that
up
fits, right?
We mix up all kinds of music,
yeah,
don't we?
We do.
Do you want to say anything about that?
No.
Not really.
We've had all these ideas you want to say about music, but.
We
just like.
What is our, do you remember our mission statement?
Our exact mission statement, I think Brandy had it up there, but our original mission statement from 19 and a half years ago was. He knows it the best. You haven't burned out all your brain cells yet.
Most of them.
But the shared vision of three instrumentalists, multi-instrumentalists, right, to kind of break down, to understand the cult.
Website.
All right, go to the But basically,
yeah, to summarize.
To summarize, to kind of go beyond political borders and things like that and bring together different kind of music that we study, we research the music, we live the music, and then to respect it, and then we can't help but, you know, for example, I'm Armenian and Syrian, my parents born in Egypt, I'm born in Montreal, so I'm a third generation immigrant, so I don't have like the luxury of some people have like, yeah, this is my home, my ancestors have been here for like one generation, 10 generations, 100, and they live in the same place and town and so on. So being kind of like a cross-cultural person myself, and just being influenced by so many kinds of music, it's always been kind of my destiny to mix up different things musically. Once again, respecting the traditions, not dealing with cultural appropriation and all that, but really getting deep into things. At the end of the day, creating our own music, because all the people that we've respected over the few hundred years really took their traditions, right? If you go way, way back, if you go middle back, or just in recent couple decades, and then you make your own thing with it. Right, and that's what we're trying to do. So we're getting rid of a little bit out of the word of like world music type thing, because it lumps up too many things together, you know, and it insults certain cultures. So we're going with.
We're thinking of calling describing our band instead of a world music trio, because world music has a lot of baggage from record labels. Basically, world music meaning non-Western music,
mm-hmm,
which, you know, there's a lot of great music beyond Western music. That we're thinking of just calling it Music Without Borders. Tell us what you think in the comments.
And it might change, too. We're always refining ourselves and refining what we do. So that's just part of it. But that's why we always give deep respect to the traditions that inspire us. And really, they're great inspirations. We're really fortunate to be saturated by so much good music.
It's true.
I'm going to let you count this one off because I don't want to count it too fast. I want to be responsible for that. Thank you. Okay.
Pretty good?
Yeah.
Tu es prêt? Thank you.
Nice. Great, Adam.
Bravo, Adam. Oh,
yeah.
Good. Beautiful tune.
Oh boy, we're really sweating now. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. We do have one more selection. Is everything going out? Going well out there, Brandy?
Oh, they're sending you so much love.
Oh.
People are disrobing?
Excellent.
And shimming. Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Excellent. Wow.
If I want to know that.
They're just having a great time.
Oh, so thank you. Thanks.
They said they want you to go all night.
You want to go all night? We might.
How many more instruments did you bring?
Yeah,
that's all I got.
It's time to pull out those ukuleles behind you, Chris. Those aren't just for second graders, you know. Oh my goodness! This event would not be made possible without the generous contribution from our sponsors.
Yes, we have Mark Lauer Realty, Carolina Drumworks, and Mosaic Realty.
Woo!
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Really appreciate it.
Seriously.
And we have a PayPal link if anyone wants to help us keep these going.
PayPal.
Is that the PayPal rhythm?
That's the PayPal rhythm for tonight. Thank you.
And a big thanks to Brandy Hubiak, who's off camera,
Brandy.
But she's the one running all the cameras
she's
and
camera.
Running the streaming and everything. So
there she is.
There she is. Give her a big hand at home. And Rima Luna for helping out.
Yeah, Rima.
Setting things up for the concert. And once again, Adam Maalouf.
Adam.
Driving up here from Greenville.
Thank you, Chris, Elliot, and River.
Yeah.
You guys are awesome.
Oh,
love the music you're making.
Oh, thank you, man. Hope to see more of you now. You're so close.
Yeah.
1 hour and 15 minutes. That's nothing for New York.
It's nothing.
It's like trying to get around the block. Yeah.
And we're going to end with our Bhangra country hoedown tune.
Wow. All right.
Speaking of mixing music.
It up. All right. I'm going to try it that way.
Thank you guys so much.
Did it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for being here. Thanks for joining us. I think Brandy will keep the chat open for a little bit, right? The chat will stop when
the video ends.
Oh, okay. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun.
Let me see if there's anything that anybody really wants responded to.
Sure. If people have any questions, that's all good.
We're planning to do another one of these at the end of October, yeah. Hopefully. We haven't nailed down the date yet.
The weekend of October, the Halloween weekend. We're thinking about doing it the Sunday. The Friday is a little tight for us, so I think they'll work on a Sunday afternoon, like
November
around 4
1st.
Or 5.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
November 1.
Hey, should Adam mention what he's going to be doing in October?
Oh, yeah. He's going to be doing a handpan workshop, right?
Yeah, we're talking about doing a handpan workshop here in Asheville at the Odyssey School. So if you're in town and you want to learn about the handpan, even if you don't own one, their instruments will be provided. It's
nice.
A 3-hour class. And really, really just a good time. It's a COVID-friendly class. We'll be wearing masks and socially distanced, so really no worries there. And we're not going to be sharing instruments as much as we normally might be. Lots of isopropyl alcohol.
Yeah.
You know, nothing to worry about.
We have so much cleansers around here. You would not believe how many times this room gets disinfected all the time. So, and we're going to try to do it outside. We have, the school has built a few tents outside and a pavilion. So we're going to start with doing it outside, and then if we have to, we go inside. We have a lot of spaces where we can stay socially distanced and so on and so forth. So hopefully that will...
October 17th.
October 17th. Yes, yeah. It's a Saturday.
Wow, that's cool. Wow.
3 weeks. Is that 3 weeks from today?
Yep.
Yeah. Come on up. Look forward to seeing you. You could all stay at Chris's house if you need a place to stay. No problem.
Yeah. Got space for a tent in the back.
Yeah. Exactly. Cool. Looking forward to that. And yeah, we just really appreciate you being here with us. We don't know when the next time we're going to play in public venue, so we're going to just do it this way for now. And it's really sweet. We dial our stuff in. We do recordings here, so hopefully the sound quality is okay. We have 16 channels going into our mixer. If you see us futzing around, by the way, we're not just really futzing around with these devices. These are our fancy mixers. We're muting, unmuting, changing levels in between. Don't worry, I'm not texting my mom in between, so it's all good. But if you're out there, Mom, I love you.
Yeah.
Hope you're doing well. Oh,
and if my dad's here, happy birthday. 75, wow. 75 years old tomorrow.
Today? Right, tomorrow. Yeah. Thank you.
Wow.
Good. Eliot loves
if
everybody.
We didn't mention you. You're our secret favorites.
Yes. Exactly.
All right.
All right.
Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank
appreciate you.
Good night.
Bye-bye. See you soon.